James sees his past. It was a foggy night on the island of Seldor, and the Fat Controller did not want all of his engines to be running around Seldor at this time of night, so he sent one of the bravest engines, Proteus and Bertram, to look after the branch line. One night at the sheds, James was teasing Mike about Bertram's ghost stories and about how boring they were. This made Mike feel very unhappy. "You know," said James, "I'm the most splendidest engines on the railway, and no one shall scare splendid engines like me, and they should scare imposters such as yourself." Mike felt hurt, and even Frank had enough. "If you're scared of the dark, James," he said, "why don't you go out alone and prove it?" This made James cross. Before they could argue, they heard an engine's whistle. Just then, Bertram the old warrior had just delivered his passenger train and came to rest in the sheds. "Your passengers are waiting," he said to James. "Oh, good," said James happily, and he set off to collect his coaches. The nighttime passengers were waiting, and at last, James buffered eagerly up to his coaches. He was coupled, he whistled, "Peep, peep, get in quickly, peep, please." The passengers got in. The guard blew his whistle, and James was on his way. For the time being, they were all going on well. James began to feel confident and was very happy, saying, "No ghosts are here to scare me," he boasted as he went up the hill. James was hurrying along when he realized he was hearing a voice. "Nice to see you again, James." James didn't know what it was, and he puffed away, ignoring the voice. But when James puffed around the line, he suddenly realized he was at the same bend where he lost control and crashed a few years ago. James stopped in shock. He saw what it was. Just then he was startled by the sound of a green engine passing by and blowing his whistle to scare him. James didn't care about the engine. All he cared about was what he saw. There, out of the fog, was himself when he crashed. But he was demonized. "Hello, James," said the Black James, as a ghostly engine. "I wasn't expecting you to see me," he said. "Have you come to face me?"
"No, I haven't," cried James. "Go away!"
And he steamed backwards.
"Oh, no, you don't, James," said the engine, and he raced out of the field where he crashed and went after James.
"Come and face me! Face me, James!"
"No!" cried James. "I don't want to face you," he said.
But he was scared even more. But by the time James ran away, he stopped. He realized that his ghostly self was gone. James was happy to not be seeing his past, although he wasn't dead. And so James puffed away. Moments after, James came back to the sheds. He didn't look like his happy self now. He was cold, scared, and very sad when he saw himself in that field where he crashed. Next to the shed where he was sleeping at was the engine he saw earlier.
"Hello, James," said the engine. "Was it me you were scared of?"
Admit it! It was me you were scared of, wasn't it? James didn't say a word. He didn't know who the engine was or what he was doing on Sodor, but that's another story.